It was extraordinary devastation. People had lost their homes, they'd lost their businesses, they'd lost all their belongings. It was absolutely as bad as you can imagine.
Western Avenue, Union Street were total devastation. We had a total of approximately 30 to 35 houses in that section involved, a lot with heavy, heavy damage. We had a lot of people displaced, people living in homeless shelters.
And I'll never forget coming to this fire station and just seeing a sea of Norwich cadets and Norwich civilian students out there mucking out, digging, working day and night. It was really extraordinary, 4,000 people hours.
I'm not sure that any of us would have been able to get through it without them.
And they didn't stop, they didn't quit, they just stayed hard at it.
And they just did whatever was asked. It didn't matter.
Like most freshmen, we had no idea what was going on. We knew a hurricane hit, and for me, it was kind of a shock because I'm from Florida, so we get hurricanes all the time. And coming up to Vermont and getting a hurricane is like, whoa, that's a rare thing.
Myself and about seven other people just went over a bridge. Someone was leading us. They dropped us out of a house, and they said, hey, clean it. Look out for dead animals.
When I opened the door, the water literally started running out of the refrigerator.
I remember one house that was probably the hardest house I worked on. I spent 5 hours straight in a basement shoving out mud, gasoline, oil, and then whatever debris was floating around there. I had no idea it was in the water.
I'd be like, guys, masks, come on, put them back on.
And there was nails floating around in the water, all kinds of wonderful stuff. That was our first day. Heavy lifting in the muck.
They took out all the furniture, the whole downstairs, carried it out to the backyard and threw it all on a burn pile.
You could say to a group of, you know, seven kids, okay, we want this basement cleaned out. Here's some buckets, here's some shovels, and we didn't have to explain to them what they needed to do. They went in, jumped into it, and went to work.
It just tore my heart out. Like, I wanted to do everything I possibly could to ease their life.
I kind of fell in love with the community, and I realized that's something I want to do further in whatever I go on to do.
Everybody, you could really tell, had a special connection with the town, and it made them feel good. It made them feel good to be helping these people who really needed us.
Initially, we were faced with a very, very devastating situation, smaller scale, obviously, but very similar to what they're going through in New York, Pennsylvania, and Jersey right now.
And what you see in them is a heightened sense of responsibility, an obligation to do the right thing for their community and for their fellow beings. That's why we've had so many leaders over the years emerge from this little great university here in Vermont.